I don't think there was an initial spark for me that I remember. I drew a lot when I was a kid. I remember doing that, but there was no. I didn't know I was going to be an artist.
Barry was a 1996 Sika Art Award winner and decided to do a site-specific wall painting on the museum's third floor landing. And then around the corner from the main piece was this installation of over 300 framed drawings and photographs that he installed in a corner. We were able to acquire the piece and bring it into the collection. We've installed it a couple times since then, and this is the fourth installation of the piece at SF MoMA since 1996.
He poses questions within contemporary art. To me, he's an important contemporary artist, but I don't really know how, in the grander scheme of things, it fits in.
One of the things I'm hoping this exhibition will reveal is the way in which the museum has supported young artists.
I'm used to things getting painted over or eliminated or destroyed, which is, there's something really refreshing in that. And then here there's there's all these things that are categorized and labeled and saved from 1996 that I wouldn't mind throwing away right now. Yeah, I think impermanence is a little more interesting to me. I'm more comfortable with things that are made while you're alive.
This piece really contains a lot of classic McGee elements, but at the same time, it also includes a lot of his current ideas, such as geometric patterns and heads drawn with ballpoint pens. And just the shape itself, the large pimple on the wall, that's something that he's been doing only in the past couple years. But I like how he's reinterpreted his own piece and how he reinterprets his own work over and over and constantly reinvents itself.
It's important that graffiti artists are involved in major institutions. I like how the work is dimensional. I like how the work is biographical in a lot of senses, that a lot of the work is individual pieces about individual stories that he's created around in his life.
Art is constantly evolving, and just like this, it looks like a natural geographic formation, like some sort of a swell, some tide, some wave. So too is art constantly in flux.
There's supposed to be a prestige to it being in a museum, but I can't distinguish what the difference between a wall in a museum or something in a cafe. I don't think it matters where I'm showing. I could show in an alleyway and be happy showing there. There's no difference. The venue doesn't mean a thing to me. I'm really happy with how the bulge part came out. It feels new somehow. I like that environment when stuff's made on the spot or installed on the spot, or if the artists are there, it's a little bit more invigorating. I like it to be made yesterday or 15 minutes ago. I always like that. I like things that are I guess current. Let my take rock.